Hey, this is Alex coming at you from Hub City Somerville, and today we're going to be doing a review on the Supreme DC Low Tops. This is a very special sneaker. This is a sneaker that you'll probably never see a review on because the amount of people who have these are very slim at this point. The shoe is also more than 11 years old. It came out in 99. What a piece to have. And it's stuff like this that really sets our stores apart. We really care about the culture and we really know enough to be able to find and curate stuff like this for you guys. This shoe has no inspiration. This is the land before time. We're not talking about gimmicks and numbers and corporate interests. We're talking about people really skating shit. So when these came out, they released to the Supreme store and there was no limited quick strike, whatever. Like you could have just walked in at any point for almost a year and they had this model. This model is called the Torreson. They had the model available in this and I think another colorway for a very long time just for anybody to casually skate. I love that. I love that so much. That's coming. That's taking a chapter out of the original era of sneaker collaborations when Undefeated would release a shoe that wasn't saying Undefeated, but was only that color there. Similar with this release here. The shoes itself, the aesthetic, they're a really premium suede. Something else worth pointing out. If a shoe looks like this after 11 years, that shit was made right. If you look at a lot of the retro, I think even more than 11 years now, because that's 99, we're in 2020, damn, yeah, you're looking at almost over 20 years on this sneaker, dude. It's like a 21-year-old sneaker. You realize how incredible it is and the quality they really put into this shoe for it to be flawless the way it is now? That's nuts. And like I said, grab any retro Jordan, go like this to the sole, and tell me it doesn't crumble on you if it's 20 years old compared to this. So it's crazy to see something like that, man, it really is. The value, these had no value for years. Supreme didn't start reselling until late 2008, in my opinion. Overseas, sure, did a little bit better. I think Japan kind of is what odd set this whole crazy shit, which I think a lot of people don't know. But it wasn't until 08 in that era that Supreme items began to garner real value. With that in mind, everybody had forgotten about these shits by then. And to this moment, these are all but forgotten. This is one of the legendary sneakers that people really don't talk about because a lot of kids don't know they exist. To me, that's a shame. And I think that a lot of this whole chunky sneaker fad that Balenciaga coined in so heavily on was literally mimicking and copying original DC sneakers. And it's nice to see DC have such a great swing back in these last 2 years. The Lynx really did it for them. Now you see DC sneakers reselling StockX, which I don't think anyone would have ever believed to be a possibility 5 years ago. So good for DC. They really turned their whole brand around and the value of their brand really upped a lot since then. The reception, as I said before, there was no real critical reception. This wasn't a shoe people were waiting on. There wasn't a release date on it. But these days, it's a shoe that garners a lot of respect from the people who do know what they are, and real Supreme fans and collectors would go bananas just at the sight of them. Like I said, there's a full grain suede leather upper. The heel counter, the heel tab, actually does have a big box logo on it printed on the leather, which I think is obviously the most striking part of the shoe. Other than the tongue saying Supreme as well, and this is kind of debossed, so you gotta get a closer look, because at a glance you might not see it. The insoles say DC for Supreme, which is sick. And the box itself has DC and Supreme co-branding throughout, which I love, and they really weren't doing boxes special back then, so this is something really cool to see. All in all, this is one of the more important pieces we'll be doing a review on, because this is knowledge that'll be lost if we don't pass it forward. Let us know what you guys think about this era. Let us know what you think about the significance of DC shoes in general, not just in skateboarding, but in fashion and trendsetting. And feel free to sound off in the comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow us. We really appreciate our viewership. And anything else you need, feel free to reach out to the YouTube. Tell us what you think. Appreciate the view. Take care, guys.